Hi everyone, welcome to this channel. In today's video, we'll be looking at the three best side hustles that you can start at the comfort of your house. This video is an extract of my course on side hustle business for creatives, the ultimate guide. And if you want the full course, you can check the link in my bio for the full 4-hour course. Now, in this video, we'll look at the three best businesses you can start at the comfort of your house. In fact, the summary of businesses that are possible out there that you can start. And as always, it will be so helpful for you to like this video and subscribe to my channel so that more people can be drawn to watch this video and start a home-based business. Without saying much, let's jump right in and get started. I want to start. So, what businesses can you start? What businesses are available out there that you can start? I will show you the businesses that are available that you can start. There are majorly three businesses that are available. It's either you're into service-based businesses, product-based businesses, or you're into influencing. Service-based businesses simply means you are selling your skills, you are selling your expertise, you are selling what you know. It's not like a product, you are selling like what you know. So you are selling your talent. And our friend here, Akabi Lame, is very well known for selling his creative side. His hand, he's selling his hand. Not, of course, literally selling his hand. But if you're on TikTok, you must have known this guy. He's always doing like this to explain concept. So his creative side, his talent, he's selling it. Some people are selling things like writing. They make a write-up and they sell it. What of graphic design? Canva is more than $1 billion because some people are selling their graphic design to other people. So when we talk of service-based business, we're looking at the skills that you have. What skill do you have? What skill do you have as an individual that you can sell to other people? Are you good with consulting? Are you good with marketing? Are you good with graphic design? Are you good with writing and making content? You can sell it. In fact, some people are selling relationship advice. They are counselors. If you have a problem with your partner, you have a problem with your children, you come and meet them. Of course, for each service, you pay them for them giving you an expertise advice. They are selling their skills to you. They're like, oh, you're having a problem with mathematics. I can teach you mathematics. And for each 1 hour I teach you mathematics, you pay me $20. They are selling what they know. So when we talk about service-based, we're like, you're serving a skill. Freelancers are well known for selling what they can do. You're like, oh, you made a video, you want an editor. Don't worry, I can edit the video for you. Just pay me. They are selling a skill to you, their editing skills. So that's what we call a service-based business. We also have what we call a product-based business. Here, you are selling a product. You are selling a product to an individual or to a company. You are selling physical items like clothing, electronics, jewelry. You are selling phone. You are selling a pen to other people. You are selling digital products too, like ebooks and online courses. You are selling a product to other people. This course you are taking, I am selling a product to you. The product is a course. And that's a good example of businesses you can start from home. So, selling digital products. It can be template, it can be print. As long as it's physical, that's what we call product-based, which means somebody can hold it. It's tangible, it's visible. But when we come to skill, it's not visible. You can't see it, it's a skill. Also, we have what we call influencing as a business you can start. A good number of you that are taking this course have watched videos on TikToks, Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, you already have it, or you're even making videos on this platform. What you are selling is your influencing skills. You are selling to people your creative side. It's very similar to a service-based business, but just that it's becoming more and more popular. That's why I decided to make it to be on its own. So you are selling a skill. It can be TikTok, you come and dance, you come and do your eyes like this, you come and do what they do on TikToks and YouTube, Instagram. In this case, you are influencing other people, so you are selling your influence. We'll go through each of these businesses step by step on the one that most align with you for you to start. So of course, we'll start with service-based business. We'll talk about influencing. Then we'll talk about product-based business for you to see the one that you can start. So are you someone that have a skill you want to sell to other people? Even if you don't have a skill you think you can sell, you can learn a skill and sell it. That's the amazing thing about side hustle. You don't need to be an expert, no. You can learn it and sell to other people. You may think you're a beginner, but there are people that have never heard about it. So you are even at a higher level than them. And then you can sell your skill to them. So don't worry, don't be angry that you don't have a skill to sell, no. There are courses on this platform you can take on how to start. And as we go through each of them, your focus is which one aligns perfectly with me, which one is in sync with who I am. So that's your focus. Which one aligns very well with your personality. So which services should I offer? So let's go to service-based system. I want to sell a service. I want to sell a skill or a creative art. Which service should I sell? Should I offer? Now, when you're looking for a service you can sell or you can offer, you must consider three things. What you enjoy doing, what you are good at, and what will people pay you for. So you are looking for this sweet spot that has the combination of the three of them. What do you enjoy doing? Some people like advising other people. Some people like making courses. Some people like dancing. Some people like talking. Some people like drawing, painting. What do you like? I like teaching, for example. So I like teaching other people. Explaining concepts to people in a simple, clear, digestible way. I like telling people about something through a step-by-step guide that A leads to B, B leads to C. And not just the process, but the reason why things happen the way they happen. I love it. I enjoy it. So that's what I enjoy doing. So what do you enjoy doing? Once you discover what you enjoy doing, what are you good at? It's not just, oh, I enjoy doing this thing, but you're not good at it. You have to be good at it. So what do you enjoy doing that you're also good at? Because for people to pay you, you must be good at it. I enjoy dancing, but I'm not good at dancing. So that's why I don't make videos about dancing, or you don't see me dancing. Not because I don't enjoy it, but I'm not good at it. So when we talk about side hustle, we're looking up for what do you enjoy doing? What are you good at? And the final part of the puzzle is what are people willing to pay you for? Even though you enjoy doing it and you are good at it, are people willing to pay you for it? You may be someone that can draw, like a painter or an artist. You enjoy painting. You are good at painting. But people are not willing to buy your product. People are not willing to buy your service. So you have to look for what you are good at, what you enjoy doing, and what people are willing to pay for. Because side hustle business, as you will discover, is it takes time to before you start making profit. Sometimes the profit is not instant, except it's in freelancing. If you're a YouTuber, you need to reach 1,000 subscribers. If you're into TikTok, you need to reach 10,000 followers. So which means before you get there, you need to do that thing over and over again. You keep doing it over and over again before you achieve the minimum requirement to be paid for it. So you have to enjoy doing it and you have to be good at it. And people must be willing or are ready to watch you, to see you. And people are enjoying the service and they are willing to pay for it. So that's the service you have to offer, a combination of these three items. That's why I've used a Venn diagram to explain to you the kind of service you should offer. So now, let's bring it home. Take a pen, take a book, and write out what you enjoy doing. Feel free, don't limit yourself. Write out what you enjoy doing. The top 10 things you enjoy doing. Out of those 10 things you enjoy doing, which of them are you good at? So, tick the ones you are good at. And the ones that you're not good at, put bad or put asterisk or put an X sign on it. And now, out of those ones that you've marked that you are good at, which one are people willing to pay for? Give it a double mark or a triple mark. Which one are people willing to pay for? That will help you to understand the service you should offer. When you're offering a service, There are different options that exist. Do you want to have your own website, or you want to go through an already established brand? Let me give you a good example of service that people are offering, which is freelancing. You are like, I can edit a video, for example. Now, if you can edit a video, or you can learn to edit a video and start editing a video, just as an example, you can have your own website where you tell people that I edit a video, or you can register yourself on Fiverr, Upwork, Freelancer, Guru, People Per Hour, and all these other established platforms in order to get customers. The choice is entirely yours, but there are pros and cons of whichever path you choose to take. The good thing actually is you can do both. If you want to go through a branded website or a third-party website, an already established website, like the ones I've listed here, there are things you enjoy, like payment protection service, which means your customers must pay. Once you've done the job, you don't ask yourself, pay me or don't pay me. No, the website will ensure that you are paid for it. This is one of the advantages you enjoy. The money comes to you without you hassling for it. They provide that payment structure for you. Also, you can list your skills at little to no cost. You can list on the website. Most of them, you don't pay, except when somebody have purchased from you, then you pay a 20% commission. If nobody has ordered a service from you, you don't pay. Also, customers seek for you when it comes to you offering a service on a branded website or on a third-party website. Customers seek for you. A good number of people know Fiverr. People are looking for editors, podcasters, voice narrators, A, B, C, already know where to find them. So they just simply go to this website. Just like you want to buy something, you just go to Amazon to buy that item. Instead of going to a website to be looking for the item, you just go to Amazon and type toothbrush or toothpaste. When we look at services, if you use a third-party website, they offer you these advantages. And for them offering you these advantages, they take a 20% cut of the sale price of the item. So if the item is listed for $100 or you sold it for $100, then they take $20, you keep $80. You could have used like $50 to have purchased the item. So your profit becomes like $30, just as an example. So because they're offering you their customers, offering you their own platform to use, they take a 20% cut for it. Some take 10%, some take 15%, but most of them take about 20% cut. So this is what happens when you use a third-party website. And I would encourage you, if you're a beginner, to use a third-party website. Because you don't have to be doing marketing to get customers. Customers come to you. It's easier for you to make a sale when you're using a trusted third-party website. But if you decide that, I want to start on my own, have my own website, I want to do it all by myself, I don't want a third-party website, I don't want anybody taking 20% cut of my money, you can also do it by yourself. Then you are a solopreneur. You are an entrepreneur that works solo. Almost like you do everything all by yourself. In that case, how you can start is by marketing your service to your family members. You reach out to your brother or your uncle, tell them that I can offer this service to you. If you're a counselor, you reach out to your friends, like, yes, you people know I can offer counseling advice. So if you want counseling, pay me and I'll offer you counseling advice. You reach out to your friends and family, telling them about your service. So you're the one now that's marketing yourself to other people on what you can offer. You probably use word of mouth. If you have a TikTok account or a YouTube account or a Facebook account, you can put it there that, yes, that I can offer this service. So if you have this problem, I can solve it for you. I can offer you service in this or in that. So if you have a problem with it, feel free to reach out to me. Send me a DM. And I will reply you as early as possible to offer you the service. And also, in order to entice them, you can give them like a free sample. They are like, okay, you write 100 pages for me. Your client is telling you, you write 100 pages for me. But they're like, I don't trust you can do this thing. So you're like, okay, don't worry. I will write 5 pages and send to you and see if you like it. If you like it, you give me the whole contract of 100 pages since you're a content writer. So you can give them like a free sample for them to have a taste of the service you can offer. And also advertise yourself with social media. Advertise yourself on social media. Tell people about the service you can offer. You'll be the one now advertising yourself. And of course, since you are the one doing it, nobody takes a cut from your money. And also, you can advertise yourself through blogs, infographics, webinars, and podcasts. You can look for different ways of advertising yourself. There's nothing wrong with doing it all by yourself. There's nothing wrong with using a branded website or a third-party website. But as a beginner, I would encourage you to go for the third party. I would encourage you to go for a branded website. Starting a business on its own is difficult. So you want to make the process as simple and as easy as possible. You may have to learn the skill. You will learn how to market. You learn how to deal with customers. You will learn how to charge. There are so many things to learn at the beginning. There are so many things you have to learn. So except you've already established yourself, I would encourage you to go for a third-party website just when you are starting. Then as you know the ups and downs, the right and the left of the business, you can scale up to have your own website and do it all by yourself. But if you are just starting, throw yourself out for the first time. You want some security. And if you want the full course, you can check the link in my bio for the full 4-hour course.